By a Sith battle fleet. The Endar Spire is under attack. Hurry up, we don't have much time. Did you fall out of your bunk and hit your head? The Endar Spire is the ship we're stationed on. This ship. You probably don't even know who I am, do you? I'm Tras Logo, ensign with the Republic Fleet. I'm your bunkmate here on the Endar Spire. We work opposite shifts. I guess that's why you haven't seen me before. Now hurry up, we have to find Bastila. We have to make sure she makes it off the ship alive. Bastila is the commanding officer on the Endar Spire. Well, not an officer, really. But she's the one in charge of this mission. One of our primary duties is to guarantee her survival in the event of an enemy attack. You swore an oath just like everyone else on this mission. Now it's time to make good on that oath. I know all about your reputation. How you used to smuggle spice and blasters along the Corellian run. I guess the Republic figured since they couldn't catch you, they might as well hire you. And I'll admit, the Republic is in desperate need of someone with your kind of skills. Desperate enough to overlook your shady past. But now that you signed on for this mission, you're part of the Republic fleet. And Bastila needs all troops at her side during this attack. So hurry up and grab your gear. You need to suit up so we can get out of here. Thank you. Come on, we have to hurry. Let's put your equipment on so... Okay, let's move out. We should stick together. You'll have more success with a party than on your own. Because of the attack, this room is in lockdown. But don't worry, I've got the override codes. You'll have to use me to unlock the door. Now that the door is open, you better take the lead again.
This is Cardinal Nassi. The Sith are threatening to overrun our position. We can't hold out long against their firepower. All hands to the bridge!
That was Karth contacting us on our portable communicators. He's one of the Republic's best pilots. He's seen more combat than the rest of the Endar Spire's crew put together. If he says things are bad, you better believe it. We have to get to the bridge to help defend Bastila. There's a map of the Endar Spire and a copy of Karth's message in your electronic journal, just in case we get separated. Codes to open. You'll have to use your security skill on it if we want to get past. Party for the Republic! With the Sith. Good thing we have med packs to heal our wounds. It might be a good idea to use one now before our next battle. Accompanying Bastila. Damn, we could have used her help. That door. You better equip your melee weapon. There isn't much room on the bridge, and it's suicide to use a blaster in close quarters. I should equip a melee weapon too. Either that or I'll have to stay back and use my blaster. Your melee weapon is made using a Cortosis weave. It's strong enough to stand up against anything, even a lightsaber. Not here on the bridge. They must have retreated to the escape pods. We better head that way too. The Sith want Bastila alive, but once she's off the ship, there's nothing stopping them from blasting the Endar Spire into galactic dust.
Thank you.
Behind here. Damn, another Dark Jedi! I'll try to hold him off. You get to the escape pods. Go!
Carthel Nassi on your personal communicator. I'm tracking your position through the Endar Spire's life support systems. Bastila's escape pod is away. You're the last surviving crew member on the Endar Spire. Now, I can't wait for you much longer. You have to get to the escape pods. But be careful. There's a Sith patrol just down the corridor. Use your stealth skill to sneak past him. First, make sure you have a stealth field generator equipped on your belt. You can't use your stealth skill without one. The generator will wrap you in a cloaking effect so you can sneak past the Sith. Just be careful you don't get too close, or you might notice someone's there. This is Carthel Nassi. Numbers. You could reprogram the damaged assault droid to help you if you have enough repair parts. Or you could use computer spikes to slice into the terminal and use the Endar Spire's security systems against the Sith.
Just in time. There's only one active escape pod left. Come on, we can hide out on the planet below.
I'm a soldier with the Republic, like you. We're the last two crew members left in the Endar Spire. Bastila's escape pod's already gone, so there's no reason for us to stick around here and get shot by the Sith. Now, come on, there'll be time for questions later. Bastila's escape pod's already gone, so there's no reason for us to stick around here and get shot by the Sith. Come on, there'll be time for questions later.
Good to see you up instead of thrashing about in your sleep. You must have been having one hell of a nightmare. I was wondering if you were ever gonna wake up. I'm Karth, one of the Republic soldiers from the Endar Spire. I was with you in the escape pod, do you remember? I'm not surprised. You took a serious blow to the head. You're probably having all kinds of strange dreams. I wouldn't worry too much about it. You've been slipping in and out of consciousness for a couple of days now, so I imagine you're pretty confused about things, but try not to worry. We're safe. At least for the moment. We're in an abandoned apartment on the planet of Terrace. You were banged up pretty bad when our escape pod crashed, but luckily I wasn't seriously hurt. I was able to drag you away from our crash site in all the confusion, and I stumbled into this abandoned apartment. By the time the Sith arrived on the scene, we were long gone. You don't have to thank me. I've never abandoned anyone on a mission, and I'm not about to start now. Besides, I'm gonna need your help.
Terrace is under Sith control. Their fleet is orbiting the planet, they've declared martial law, and they've imposed a planet-wide quarantine. But I've been in worse spots. I saw on your service records that you understand a remarkable number of alien languages. That's pretty rare in a raw recruit.
but it should come in handy while we're stranded on a foreign world. There is no way the Republic will be able to get anyone through the Sith blockade to help us. If we're going to find Bastila and get off this planet, we can't rely on anybody but ourselves. That smack to your head did more damage than I thought. Bastila's a Jedi. She was with the strike team that killed Darth Revan, Malak's Sith master. Bastila's the key to the whole Republic war effort. The Sith must have found out that she was on the Endor Spire and set an ambush for us in this system. I believe Bastila was on one of the escape pods that crashed down here on Terrace. For the sake of the Republic war effort, we have to try and find her. I don't, but Bastila's young, and she has a powerful command of the Force. We survived the crash landing, so I'm willing to bet that she may have too. Besides, what's the alternative? I mean, if she's dead, then no one can stop Malak and his Sith from wiping out the Republic, and I'd rather operate on the assumption that she survived. Bastila is no ordinary Jedi. She has a rare gift the Jedi call battle meditation. Bastila's power can influence entire armies. Through the Force, Bastila can inspire her allies with confidence and make her enemies lose their will to fight. Often that's all it takes to tip the balance in a battle. Of course, there are limits to what she can do, but from what I understand of her ability, it requires great concentration and focus to maintain her battle meditation. The attack on the Endar Spire happened so fast, she never had a chance to use her battle meditation. Like us, she barely got out alive. Bastila's gonna need our help. Many of Darth Malak's followers can use the dark side of the Force, and the Sith have already killed more than their share of Jedi in this war. Nobody will be looking for a couple of common soldiers like us, and if we're careful, we can move about the planet without attracting notice, a luxury Bastila won't have. She's gonna have half the Sith fleet looking for her. They know how important she is to the war effort. The whole planet is under quarantine. No ships can land or take off. So if Bastila's gonna escape Terrace, she's gonna need our help. And we'll probably need hers. While you were out, I did some scouting around. There are reports of a couple escape pods crashing down into the Undercity. It's probably a good place to start. But the Undercity's a dangerous place. We don't want to go there unprepared, and it won't do Bastila any good if we go and get ourselves killed. Good idea. We can use this abandoned apartment as a base. We can probably get some equipment and supplies here in the upper city. Just remember to keep a low profile. I've heard some grim stories about the Dark Jedi interrogation techniques. They say the Force can do terrible things to a mind. It can wipe away your memories and destroy your very identity. But I figure if we don't do anything stupid, we should be okay. I mean, after all, they're looking for Bastila, not a couple of grunts like us. All right, soldier, let's move out.
Right, you alien scum. Everybody, get up against the wall. This is a raid.
Rabona nin kismat toga. Tuk nin nang kong. Namurira rabes. Wana kong bes. King Damurira. Tuk king ba nung kong nek.
That's how we Sith deal with smart-mouthed aliens. Now the rest of you, get up against the wall before I lose my temper again.
What's this? Humans hiding out with aliens? They're Republic fugitives! Attack!
Discard Usuki Gumba, the Mona Naitachu, of Tonikotu, the Kuyamichus Kunaji Kanai, Inakuma Marunira Rajikuni, Sleep. Jawana Bota, are you at Tahunga Chakanki Dora? Kachiku Ita Hodonga? Topa da bunk walia gando do nano chut chut. Uba Batu Gonchi. Tom Nong Bong Shan.
Are you? What are you doing in here? You can't just come barging into someone's home. That's no excuse. You can't just go around barging into people's apartments because you're curious. But at least you're more polite than that pig Holden. Just one of Darvik's men who can't keep his hands to himself. But all he got for his trouble was a nasty scar from my vibroblade. Too bad I'm the one still paying the price. I don't want to talk about it. I'm in enough trouble already. Besides, I don't know if I can trust you. Well, I suppose you seem like an all right sort. When I cut Holden, it made him back off, but it also embarrassed him in front of his friends. Holden's a spiteful little hut slug. He went and put out a bounty on my head for what I did. That's why I'm hiding out here. I doubt it. Holden is one of Darvik's men. When you work for the local crime lord, the authorities tend to turn a blind eye. I'm afraid this is between me and Holden now. You could try, I guess. He usually hangs out at the cantina in the lower city. It probably won't do any good. Holden's used to getting his own way. That's one of the fringe benefits of being a goon for Darvik. Working for the local crime lord lets you get away with things. Still, I appreciate the offer. Goodbye and good luck. I hope you can talk some sense into Holden.
Tong haitwam chichi jump lumpa. Nita poe tikito. Dolpa da bongwaleo gandona chuchut.
Runda di hotonga kun hunkabi. Wana kun bez ching palamul.
Chi gratu loda pograshi onion kumpa chin tomba muchuba. Loda di ta kun. Ita kung justach miki grabble mogo.
And I can tell you from experience that they aren't any good at all against a simple vibroblade. That's why the Republic has been training soldiers in hand-to-hand and melee combat.
Tolbabank, waleo ganda nanu chi gratu loda pograshi onion kumpa chin tombo muchuba.
Tolpa da bank wale gando nangugu chuchut. Kavadum ku pilio. Runda di hotonga kun hankabi. Wana kun bez tong abog sha umni nang. Wanga kun bez.
Tag, bis du bonko cookie mac panka. Ching pala chiska. Chan shok bulara. Umrao chiska duchi. On chuban jiska.
Oui, tam boragatong. Mulira a shang turung omni.
Chi gratu loda. Bograshi onni un kompa chin tombo muchuba. Mucho shak pachat. Ki yinu no dama paole rachi. Achuta.
Thank you. pudu. Tuni rama na praka donko pudu. Tuni rama na praka donko searcha. Chupa punky. Dumpa kapaliamo na pata, bona na kachu. Yin kin kun no ba mule rachi kun, tong na bun shanu yang.
Hey there, what were you walking? I just cleaned those floors. Well, all right, then. No hard feelings. My name's Kadir. I'm the janitor for this building. You must be the new tenant here, right? Never thought they'd rent that abandoned apartment. You look like an off-worlder. What happened? You get stuck here because of the quarantine? Can't see any other reason someone would want to rent that old apartment. I should get back to work anyway. I'll probably see you around.
Yes, what's on your mind? Terrace? Well, the planet's all one big city, but its golden years are long past, and things have gotten worse since the Sith occupied it. From what I hear, the wealthy live on the tops of all the tall towers, and if you're poor, you live down in the shadows, and it gets worse the lower you go. Well, that's all I can think of, at any rate. Me? Well, I've been a star pilot for the Republic for years, seen more than my share of wars. I fought in the Mandalorian Wars before all this started. But with all that, I've never experienced anything like the slaughter these Sith animals can unleash. Not even the Mandalorians were that senseless. My homeworld was one of the first planets to fall to Malak's fleet. The Sith bombed it into submission, and there wasn't a damn thing our Republic forces could do to stop them. It shouldn't be my fault. I did everything I could. I followed my orders and did my duty. That shouldn't mean I failed them. I didn't. No, I know. Don't worry about it. I must not be making much sense. You probably mean well with your questions. I'm just not accustomed to talking about my past very much. At all, actually. I'm more used to taking action, keeping my mind focused on the business at hand. So let's just do that. If you have more questions, ask them later.
Hello there. I haven't seen you in my shop before. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Kebla Yurt. Welcome to the Equipment Emporium. You looking to buy some supplies? My shop's the largest one in all of Upper Terrace. Best selection on the planet. Whatever you need, I've got. Well, mostly.
Mostly? What do you mean by that?
The Sith confiscated all my heavy weapons, and they impounded all my ships and swoop bikes. But I've still got a real nice selection, if you're interested.